Hello students, today we will study about the chemical reactions of haloarenes and here we will study about the nucleophilic substitution reaction. See, nucleophilic substitution reaction, it is a reaction in which the stronger nucleophile, it substitute the weaker one. Okay, so here first we will see substitution by hydroxy group. It means, since we are talking about haloarenes, it means halogen atom, it is replaced by hydroxy group, that is OH. Okay, now we will see how this will happen. When a haloarene, it is heated with an aqueous solution of NaOH at 623 Kelvin. See, temperature is 623 Kelvin. At that temperature, under a pressure of 300 atmosphere, when it is heated, the halogen atom, it is replaced by an OH group, and if it is being replaced by a OH group, see, phenoxide is obtained. Okay, phenoxide is obtained, and the phenoxide, upon first phenoxide will be obtained, and then it will be replaced, or then that Na will be replaced by H. Now we will see how this is happening here. See, chlorobenzene is here. This chlorobenzene, when it will combine with sodium hydroxide at 623 Kelvin, 300 atmosphere pressure is there, then we will get this. See, this Cl and this H will combine to form HCl. What is left there? ONa. This ONa will combine here. ONa. And this is phenoxide, sodium phenoxide. This is phenoxide, okay? And sodium is attached over here, so this is sodium phenoxide. Now what we have to do, see, we have to replace it completely by hydroxy group, OH group. It means we have to replace this Na by H. So here what we will do, we will remove NaCl. When we will add dilute HCl to it, on adding this dilute HCl, NaCl will be removed. If Cl and Na, these will be removed, O will be combined here to form phenol here. So if you have to convert any haloalkane to phenol, so first you have to add sodium hydroxide, and the temperature, it should be 623 Kelvin, and pressure, it is 300 atmosphere. Then we will obtain sodium phenoxide, and then this sodium phenoxide, to the sodium phenoxide, dilute HCl is added. Then we will obtain phenol. So, haloarene to phenol. Now, second is by amino group. It means, in place of Cl, there will be amino group. Okay. When haloarene, it is heated with aqueous ammonia in the presence of cuprous oxide. This is Cu2O cuprous oxide, and this cuprous oxide, it is acting as a catalyst here. The temperature here, it is 475 Kelvin and pressure is 60 atmosphere. Halogen atom, it is replaced by amino group. So at this temperature, when liquid or aqueous ammonia, it is added in presence of copper oxide, the temperature is 475 and pressure is 60 atmosphere. At that, in this condition, this chlorobenzene, it will convert to aniline, benzene and NH2. It means here, this Cl, it is replaced by NH2 group. Along with that, we will get Cu2Cl2 and water. Now, cyano group. When haloarenes are treated with cuprous cyanide, CuCN, cuprous means, here it is in plus one state and this is CN minus one. Cuprous cyanide, when it will combine with cuprous cyanide, the temperature here, it is 475 Kelvin, and substance here used is pyridine. With in presence of pyridine, cuprous cyanide will combine with chlorobenzene. And what we will get? This Cu and Cl will combine to form CuCl, and this CN will be attached over here. It means these nucleophiles are more stronger than the halogen atom. Okay. Now see what will happen here. This we have studied in haloalkenes also. we have obtained cyanobenzene or phenyl cyanide. This we have obtained. Now hydrolysis is done. In presence of conch HCl or alkaline H2O2, partial hydrolysis will take place. When partial hydrolysis will take place, we will obtain CONH2 amide, benzamide. Upon partial hydrolysis, we will obtain benzamide. Okay, same. Now see what will happen next. See, here also cyanobenzene is there. When it will combine with dilute HCl, water, here complete hydrolysis is taking place. See, here it was conch HCl or alkaline H2O2. Conch HCl or alkaline. And there what we have taken? We have taken dilute HCl. So here complete hydrolysis will take place and we will not get benzamide. We will get benzoic acid. See, these conversion reactions are very important. What we have obtained first, chlorobenzene was there. And from this chlorobenzene, we can obtain benzamide also. From this chlorobenzene, we can obtain benzoic acid also. First, we will add CuCN, we will get cyanobenzene. And this cyanobenzene, when it will combine with dilute HCl in presence of water, complete hydrolysis will take place and we will get benzoic acid. See, benzene and COH. This is oic acid and benzoic acid. And along with this, we will get NH4Cl also. Here, see, reduction is taking place. It was hydrolysis. Now, here, reduction is taking place. And reduction means here, addition of hydrogen will take place. This is cyanobenzene. Hydrolysis is taking place. See, lithium aluminium hydride can be used. Or sodium in ethanol, it can also be used. Reduction is taking place here. We will get amino phenyl methane. See, its name is amino and phenyl. Two groups are attached to this methane, one carbon. This is one carbon here. Two hydrogens are attached here. And to this place, NH2 is added and here phenyl group is added. So, amino phenyl methane we will obtain upon reduction of cyanobenzene. So, from chlorobenzene, we can also obtain amino phenyl methane. Now, it is also playing an important role, this thing, effect of substituents on the reactivity of haloarenes. Substituents means other than haloarene or halogen atom, if any other atom is also present over there in the benzene ring, then what will be the effect on the incoming nucleophile? What will be the effect of that group which is present along with Cl? What will be the effect of that group on the incoming nucleophile? See, presence of electron withdrawing group. If any electron withdrawing group is present there at ortho and para position to the halogen atom, if this is the halogen atom, and if any other group which is electron withdrawing group, if such group is present at ortho to this chlorine or at para to this chlorine, here in either in these two places or here, then it will greatly activate the halogen towards the nucleophilic substitution reaction. So, it will enhance the nucleophilic substitution reaction here. Like, see, here what we are having? We are having chlorobenzene. When this chlorobenzene, it was reacting with NaOH at 623 Kelvin and 300 atmosphere. And dilute HCl was also added there. Firstly, phenoxide was being obtained there. And then that phenoxide was combining with dilute HCl to give phenol. This we have studied here now. This one, this reaction, NaOH, this is combining at 6, this and this, then phenoxide and then dilute. Here, in this reaction, they have directly written dilute HCl here only and phenol was formed. Yes. Now see, if this nitro group is present at the para position to this chloro group, what is written over here? Presence of the electron withdrawing group at ortho and para position. Ortho or para position to the halogen atom. So it is present at the para position to the halogen atom. This is 4 nitrobenzene. When this will combine with NaOH, this 4 nitrobenzene will combine with NaOH. See what is happening here. The temperature it has been reduced to 433 Kelvin. The temperature here it was 2623 Kelvin, and now here it has been reduced to 433 Kelvin, and we have obtained what? 4-nitrophenol. This is phenol, and 4 nitrophenol. So the temperature it has been reduced just because of the presence of one nitro group, one electron withdrawing group only. Now if suppose two withdrawing groups are present here, if two electron withdrawing groups are present here, same reaction we are talking about. See, the temperature it has been reduced. There it was 433, from 623 to 433 to 368 Kelvin. Reaction is same, but due to the presence of these, like catalyst, it enhances the rate of a reaction. In a similar way, these electron withdrawing group are enhancing the nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, so here we will get, see, this is phenol, and to the second and fourth position nitro groups are attached. So 2,4-dinitrophenol we will obtain. Yes, now see here what is there. This is again now to both the ortho positions and to the para positions. See, this is also ortho to this chlorine. This is also ortho to this chloro group. Okay, and this is the para one. So if in these all the three positions, if nitro group is present, we will just warm it in presence of water only. No need to add NaOH. No need to increase the temperature so much. No need to add this and we will just warm it, and just by warming we will get, see, this is phenol, and 2,4,6 trinitrophenol we will obtain. So this is the effect of the substituent group on the reactivity of halovarine. If any substituent or electron withdrawing group is present along with the halogen atom there in the benzene ring, then that group will enhance the nucleophilic substitution reaction, or it will greatly activate the substitution of the halogen. So this was about the nucleophilic substitution reaction. Thank you.